Chris Lang from G+ Nights is with me. And Chris, can you give me an overview on Google Plus? People ask me all the time, how's Google Plus different from Facebook?
Well, let's see, let's call it five bullet points. Number one, probably the thing that will benefit the average everyday user the most is you can edit your Google Plus post after you have created it. Facebook, Twitter, you're kind of locked in with what you make a typo, say maybe you jump on the news a little too fast and maybe over exaggerate something, as a lot of us are apt to do at times, you're able to go back and edit that post. That's probably the most beneficial thing to the average person. Secondly, Google Plus is an open social network. It's built on being open more than anything else.
Facebook. What do you mean by open?
Open being, for the most part, everything almost should be publicly posted. It's completely open to begin with. Even though I'm not logged in, you can go to profiles.google.com/Chris Lang, and you can see my profile. Now, if I haven't posted anything publicly, you're not going to see anything there. So you can mix public, personal, private, targeted just to certain niches. And most of what you're probably going to post, if you're a marketer like me, is going to be public. So you can just, so the fix early on with Facebook was to create pages that were public to fix the heavy privacy, original friend to friend, mutual friend settings within Facebook. Google Plus was meant to be public to begin with, just like Google Profiles. I think the second to create a Google profile in 2008, just behind Robert Scoble. Google profiles were always meant to be public. They were meant to be a business card, a virtual Google business card for your business and is in your own personal name. So Google Plus is meant to be open and public, fully indexed by any search engine, easily aggregated by outside applications, hopefully a broader API released. And third, Facebook is followed up now with lists and the ability to post only to your friends and post publicly. Google Plus was built originally to be, you know, open to everyone and be able to aggregate whatever you like, as we're hoping we're going to see YouTube more closely aggregated into the video tab. So that's just, and then of course we have circles, and circles were the first big difference. We've seen lists come to Twitter, and we've seen multiple posting venues and lists come to Facebook. But circles really led that way into being more of an open social network. If you go back to the early social networks like Dig, StumbleUpon, Reddit, Delicious, your profile was public, and it was meant to be, you know, kind of a micro blog very early on. You were meant to be able to share things with everyone if you cared to. And that's what Google Plus has brought back around as we've come full circle, going to the walled gardens and higher privacy and mutual friends. And now we're coming back to more of an open social network where we share with the world a blog style.
It's pretty cool. You watch the development. Well, he's Chris Lang from gplusnights.com. For more information, find him on the web. Plus, we've got a lot more coming up about Google Plus.